The treasurer's house, a hidden gem tucked away near the Minster. It used to be owned by a wealthy industrialist, Frank Green, from 1897 to 1930. In the home, Frank showcased his collection of art and antiques that he gained whilst travelling around the world.
Frank gave the house to the National Trust in 1930, and I think the thing that's really special about treasurers is that he gave the house to the Trust so that we could open it up to the public. So people have been visiting since 1930, and he loved that. He wanted people to feel engaged with history. He wanted people to come and have a look at his house and see all of his things. So that makes it really different to other National Trust houses, which are kind of houses that are given to the Trust because people didn't have money to keep them. Frank was always like, no, I want people to come around and enjoy, take a look. One thing that visitors do notice is that every room around the house is decorated like it's from a different period of time, which makes for a really interesting journey because you go in the Great Hall and that's really medieval, looks like something from the Tudor times, and then you go into the blue drawing room and that's like French Palace of Versailles, and then upstairs we've got like medieval panelled bedrooms and things like that. So every room is different as you're walking around. It's really interesting.
The 13 period rooms are filled with antique furniture, ceramics and paintings from a 300-year heritage. From a clock with a 13-foot pendulum that only measures time by the hour to an 18th century chairs with eyes. There's a real eclectic mix.
These buildings are so unique, they're really special, and there's things in them that you wouldn't find anywhere else. So our housekeeping team work really hard, super high. They're winding up clocks, they're dusting furniture, they're keeping everything in tip-top condition, because people come around and they're surprised. And that was one of Frank's intentions. He bought pieces that could intrigue people or be surprising, so that people would think, oh gosh, you know, it's really interesting. Especially children, when you see children coming around, it's really rewarding because they will probably pick out things that even I've never noticed, you know, just because they're so observant.
The new oddities tour showcases the quirks of the house.
So it's a new tour for this summer, and visitors can pick up like a map and a leaflet, and there are points along the way where we've highlighted some things are kind of hiding in plain sight almost. You'd miss them if you didn't have them pointed out, and those little bits of detail that can be quite surprising, or things that we don't really know the answer to anyway, and that we leave it up to visitors to say, you know, what's your best guess about why this might be as it is.
In September, the National Trust are holding a Heritage Open Day where York residents can visit for free and go on a treasure hunt of their own. Anna Riley, That's TV.